Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we're going to do week 5 assignment of ethical hacking course from NPTEL. So the first question is, which of the following tools can be used for scanning vulnerabilities? So hypervisor is a virtual machine monitor like Oracle, so it is not a tool that is used for scanning vulnerabilities. Nexus is a tool that is used for scanning vulnerabilities, and Nmap is also a tool that is used for Hydra is used for brute force. So these B and D are the answers of first question. Second is, which of the following may be used for password cracking? So for password cracking, we can use dictionary attack, which means we have a list of common passwords and we are spraying it against, you know, some users. And social engineering means tricking the user into getting his password. And for the third, we have, which of the following can be used for gaining higher privileges than existing ones? So there are two methods of escalating privileges. First is horizontal and second is vertical. So in horizontal privilege escalation, we don't escalate our privileges, but we shift from a user to another user that has the same privilege. And in vertical privilege escalation, we gain higher privilege user. We shift to a higher privilege user. So the answer would be vertical privilege escalation. Which of the following can self replicate itself? So Trojans cannot self replicate itself and ransomware cannot. So viruses and worms are the two which can self replicate itself. So the answer will be virus. Which of the following can be performed using Nmap tools? Identify open ports on a target system. Yes, Nmap can do this. Identify the operating system that is running on an operating system. Dash O flag in Nmap. We can do this. Identify the host available in a network. Yes, we can also do this. And vulnerability available on a target system. There is a dash dash script option, and we can specify the vulnerability as well we are looking for. So all these can be done using the Nmap tool. So all are correct for fifth question. Sixth is, which of the following Nmap commands are used to run an Nmap script? Script name dot nse. So the first two are correct because the syntax is Nmap dash dash scripts equals to script name, and we can also give a space and specify the script name. One thing you have to note that this .nse extension, we don't need to add it. It can automatically add this .nse extension, but this also works like script name .nxe, or we don't specify. So these three are the correct options for this, and this dash dash script is not in the D option, so three options are correct. Which of the following HTTP scripts can be used to detect if a target system is running a web server? So HTTP methods, there is a mistake here, you forgot to place the D here, so it is actually HTTP methods. Okay, so which of the following approaches can be used to create a secure hacking environment? So in order to create a secure hacking environment, we can use proxy tools and servers, and we can also make use of a MAC changer tool, which is in order to change the MAC address of our target system, and proxy and tools and servers in order to hide behind, you know, a proxy. Because when you are using a proxy, we are sending our traffic from server to the target, and there is kind of a barrier that is we are sending it through a server, and that server is then connecting it to the target. For example, if I have a proxy running and I want to connect to NPTEL ethical hacking website, and then I will have to go through a proxy that I've used, and after that my traffic will go from proxy to NPTEL ethical hacking. So assume that you want to connect to a target system. This through SSH service. The username and password are user and password respectively. Which of the following commands can be used to create a SSH connection? So in order to create a SSH connection, we can use SSH specifying the user and using @ and specifying the IP, and then it will ask for your password. And we can also use this SSH IP-L to specify user, and then we enter and it will ask for password. So the C option is incorrect syntax, and D is also incorrect because dash P is not used for password. It is, I guess, used for specifying the port or something, but it is not used to specify the password in SSH, dash P flag. Which of the following approaches can be used to enumerate all users available in target? So we can use this Nmap script SMB enum users to enumerate all the users available in a target system, and we can also use this enum for Linux tool. It is also a tool that can enumerate all users. So which of the following ports should be open on our target system to run a nmap script HTTP malware host? So we have to check if the HTTP server is running or not, that is port 80 is running or not. So I think the answer should be HTTP. I think it should be HTTP. In an attack using the remote administrative tool, that is RAT, which part of the tool needs to be placed in a target system? So basically we have to place the server part in the target system in which we are attacking. So server will be the answer. Which of the following protocols are not vulnerable to sniffing? So all these protocols, that is HTTP, Telnet, POP3, that is post office protocol, SMTP, simple mail transfer protocol, they all send the traffic in plain text except HTTP. So I think HTTPS, except HTTPS. So except HTTPS, all these send the traffic in plain text and can be, you know, vulnerable to sniffing. So HTTPS is the only option that is not vulnerable to sniffing because it encrypts the traffic. The major loophole of ARP is that a host can send unlimited number of ARP requests. Yes, I think it is correct because what we do is we send unlimited ARP requests to the switch and it gets overload and it starts behaving like a hub, and then we can, you know, do ARP spoofing or poisoning. So I think it should be true. Which of the following commands is used to see the ARP table? So the command is simple, ARP-A is used to see the ARP table. So that completes our week 5 assignment of ethical hacking. And thank you for watching.